and I'll, does make it pretty difficult for a lot of the dive champions.
I would potentially keep my eyes out for even a lane swap, because we got the tank top lane, mm-hmm. we got a rough bot lane matchup, maybe Diggentoth ends up looking for an early swap.
He can actually get through as a Zenith Blade, gonna whiff. Speaker's behind them,
they
though.
They know about Speaker.
They don't know.
It does not appear so. Busio and Masu, gonna have to be careful about this one. Speaker makes his entry. Masu and Busio, they aren't afraid about this at all. Speaker now having to flash away as the re-engage comes out from Isles, but now he has to flash two. 3v2, these boys are losing it. Dignitas is getting styled and flying.
And then Inspire's getting free grubs. So he's potentially down three camps or even more if they can invade topside.
Yeah, that is really big. And Licorice, you know, is going to take his first base now on topside. He will have to TP back and catch this wave. Bwipo, of course, does still have his TP, but Dignitas at the very least will take one grub away, which is actually quite big. You get a lot of bonus XP on that first grub. Pushing that wave, wanted to kill off the last cannon, and Quad is hitting him, exactly.
Yeah. No, yeah, this matchup around, especially like level
2v3 bot, right? You went into lane swap, so you're opting into giving up two plates guaranteed to them. Then you lose the 2v3, all of a sudden, the matchup becomes unplayable. You're stuck under your tower, you're not going to be able to
even the first item fully completed now on the Kalista there with the opportunity. And Dignitas is going to try to at least take something here, but FlyQuest are making their way over. First grub belongs
to
Dig.
Scared. This fight is so scary. Kalista's the only person on the map with the item, so she's so strong coming into this fight. Great tally wall.
Inspired blocks everybody off, forces the flash over the wall from Speaker, and it looks like Licorice is the sacrifice. FlyQuest are going to pick up a kill. They're going to have control over the topside river. They're going to get these last two grubs.
Honestly, that wall from Inspired was just insane. It trapped like four people in that little corner there and just either forces them to die like Licorice did or like use your flash out.
Yeah, that was a really nice angle on the wall. They clearly just wanted to try to get one grub, and so they did get the one grub. They tried to get out, but they weren't able to do so in time.
And it looks like Inspired is not going to be challenged whatsoever here for the second Drake. So FlyQuest, they've got four grubs to two.
They're bot side, they have so much control bot side. Now they're top side, they're just taking Rift Toe, they take Dragon. Like, it becomes a point, when do they start to let, or when does Dignitas start to play?
Honestly, I think that would be a pretty kick-ass feature if we could have spectator all chat.
We can actually
numbered fights, because you're also up against Taliyah, who can instantly change even a fair fight to an unfair one, as Jensen's jumping in after Quad, but Quad's ready to fire right on back. Busio making his way up through the tribe rush, looking for the dive. Jensen gets away as the teleports are coming in from both sides, but Jensen's going to die in the back end anyway. Meanwhile, you got Isles going in after Masu, shut down back over to Leona, as Licorice is in a 1v2. It doesn't look like he's going to be able to get himself away from this one, and they cut him down. Sven and Isles on the run, but they're running into the FlyQuest jungle. Sven gets away, but Quipo is ready and waiting. There's the barrier. I don't think that's going to do a damn thing. Ace.
Forward, and he just started getting blasted in that 1v1. Fell very far behind early on.
This is a pretty bad spot.
Here comes Inspired. Okay.
Tristana BN. Inspired is gonna find him. Sets it up, Jensen, for Inspired. Honestly, man, there's still only that one kill this whole game for Dignitas.
Yes, even though, like, he himself has not been the one in a lot of these plays.
And there's
Bounty
the
there. And then you fight for Soul, you fight for Baron, nothing else.
Oh, Quad gets jumped on, but now he can immediately just jump back away. Isles is on the front line, and he immediately falls. Quad's going to take another kill. Dignitas now down a man, and they're about to be down another. Sven trying to escape from Inspired, but it ain't going to work. Inspired goes on a kill. 10,000 gold, and Busio decided that Mikhail's is a great item to buy when the only chance they have is making a pick with the Leona. FlyQuest pick up the Baron. Absolutely no.
Because there were so many bans thrown towards it, or was there a specific pick you would have still preferred them go, even with everything that had been banned out?
I think it differs from team to team. But I think, like, to me, Ezreal and Varus are, like, two big components to match with the Leona.
Ward's being placed down, Dignitas being forced back. It looks like FlyQuest know exactly what they're going for. And what they're going for is Isles. He has to flash the seismic shove just to get away. The Weaver's wall will collapse in time for him to complete his escape. But what about Jensen? He's now the guy who's got to be careful. Isles goes in with a Zenith Blade. They've locked up Quad, but it ain't going to matter. Isles down to 200 HP. Quad dies first. Nicely done from Dignitas. But it is going to be a mid laner for mid laner trade. 4v4. But Sven and Isles are both at death's door. They have to try to get away from this one. But Bwipo's still chasing him. Speaka wants to get out, but it ain't going to happen. Masu gets the kill as Bwipo's flash stun set it up. Licorice, Sven, and Isles all still running. They have no way to try to contest this upcoming Drake here in about 10 seconds. Sven's still at about 100 HP, trying to get away from Wimpo. He escapes for now. They're trying to turn their attention back over to the FlyQuest top laner, but it ain't going to matter. Licorice knocks the Croc
straight back
away.
To Sven. Sven's
back in the face. That is all knocked.
And Licorice doesn't even live.
They just passed the ball over to him. A turret kills him. I guess that's about the best thing you could hope for on Dignitas's side right now. A double kill for Inspired.
Really no chance for Dignitas in this first game, but they are trying to find angles, trying to find nothing left, and you're chunked, and then all of a sudden you have to deal with four other
guys who are also god.
Uh-oh. Looks like we got even more problems. Another beautiful handshake from Busio. Uses the flash to guarantee another death for Jensen.
See, I thought the series was going to be close, but honestly, after watching game one, I'm not so convinced.
Yeah, this is not a good showing from Dig. FlyQuest are just stomping them 16-2. And now, with the enemy mid laner and AD carry both dead for the next 25 seconds, it should be real easy for FlyQuest to wrap up this first game.
This might be the push here.
Yeah, first inhibitor turret's already gone. Inhibitor's going to follow. Here comes the Weaver's Wall just to make defending that much more impossible. Spica, again, gonna be forced to flash just to try to stay alive. Whippo gets stunned as he goes in, and he'll kill the enemy jungler right on the steps of the fountain. It's another ace for FlyQuest. It's a 19-2 game, and
stop.
It ain't even close. Jensen's alive. They're still looking to make an extra statement here. They're still looking to prove their point and rub Dignitas's faces in it. FlyQuest are taking it slow and steady because they already won the race. Sven at least gets a kill on Busio, but it's 19-3, and FlyQuest absolutely.